Good morning, guys, from Phoenix, Arizona. This is crazy. I have not held this camera in about 11 months, actually closer to a year. But today I'm going to be hopping on a Delta Airlines Boeing 767-400 from Phoenix to Atlanta. But I just kind of wanted to make a vlog, not necessarily a trip report, just to record the whole day. Because it's been so freaking long since I've recorded a video. I mean, it's pushing a year. I'm still uploading videos from my last trip in Europe, but it's crazy to me that it has been a year. So this is gonna be like my first experience during COVID flying and stuff and recording, but I'm ready to do this. This will be the first time in the new Delta Terminal 2 here at Phoenix, which is awesome. And probably my last time on a 767 from Delta, but yeah, so that's sad. But I got lucky. I didn't even know I was going to be on a 767-400 from Phoenix to Atlanta, which is crazy. So super excited about that. And I'm also staying at the Renaissance Hotel in Atlanta, so I'll be able to shoot some cool shots for you guys there. For those of you who don't know, that's like one of the most famous plane spotter hotels there is. So I'll be able to get some cool shots there for you guys because I have a runway view room. And yeah, I've never been to Atlanta, so let's go hop in an Uber, go to the airport, and fly across the country. So I just stood in line for about 30 minutes. That kind of sucked, but I finally checked my bag. Gonna go through security, and I have one carry-on. But the guy that was working was really nice, so it worked out. So maybe grab a coffee if I have time. About 30 minutes until I get on, and yeah. Excited to check out this new terminal too. This is my first time post-security here. I flew out once a couple years ago, but this is brand new, so. Should be pretty spectacular. Let's check it out. If you guys don't know, I do martial arts. So the purpose of this trip is mainly actually to compete at a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu tournament in Atlanta. And then from there, I'm gonna drive up from Georgia to Pennsylvania, which is where I grew up, for Thanksgiving. And then next week I will fly back to Arizona, but it should be a fun time. This is like the first time I've been home in about 2 years to Pennsylvania, so it's exciting stuff. Just got past security there, and yeah, this is a cool little view here. So, gonna go get some gum and then head to the gate and on board to Atlanta. Let's do it, guys. What they did with this terminal is insane to me because I've heard about it for years, about how great it was gonna be, but it is really, really beautiful. I mean, look here. You can see, I mean, so much nicer than the... Yo, what's up, man? So much nicer than the previous Terminal 2, which was super depressing, which I shot a lot out of because I used to fly United a lot about a year ago. And until then, it was just such a terrible little terminal, unfortunately. I don't like to trash stuff, but I mean, it had like one restaurant. It was all old. So to see this is really great, and to make sure United has a good home now here too, it's pretty awesome. The gate area here has about like a minute until we start boarding, and I'm going to be in seat 51G, so that's cool, and we'll see. It's kind of weird flying on a 767-400 domestically. Like, I feel like I should be going to Europe or something right now, but just going to Atlanta, and I'm interested to see the time difference. So it's usually about 3.5 hours on a normal A321 from Phoenix to Atlanta. So I'm interested to see if it takes a little bit shorter to get there on this this 400. I don't know if that's focused. There we go. Sorry about that. And that's about it. This terminal is incredible. I mean, there's everything here from food, drinks. I don't know why I keep losing focus. I think it's because of the light. But food, drinks, anything you want is here, plus shopping. Nice, new, and modern. And they did a really good job here. Another shot for you guys. If you want to check it out,
And then my gate is down there at F10.
So.
And then they kind of separate it, so there's like a main concourse area, and then there's the E gates, I believe, and F gates, and my flight was at the F gates, so yeah. Another thing too, if you haven't traveled post-COVID, make sure you have a mask, because they will enforce it here in the airport and on board. I don't fly too much anymore, so sad times. But still, this is fun. Feels good to be traveling again, finally. So the in-flight entertainment system on Delta is really great. There's a huge selection of movies and TV shows you can choose from, as well as the mini-map, which is my favorite feature. Especially if you're on a shorter flight, you can definitely stay entertained because there's just a lot to watch in general. Old movies, new movies, pretty much anything you can think of relatively is on here, which is great. And in my opinion, they have the best IFE out of the big three major carriers in the United States. And I'll run through the rest of the system here and let you guys kind of get a sense of what the IFE is like.
to Atlanta after a really nice run on Delta. Now it is time just to go get my bag and then head to the airport hotel and hop in an Uber and maybe get some food. Kind of sleepy, so maybe a coffee. The first time I've been to Atlanta and actually left the like airside area, because every time I've come here I've either been connecting or like I used to come here when I was younger with my friends and record like videos when I was super young, like plane spotting and stuff, but this is like the first time I've actually been outside of the main area, so it's interesting. It's kind of weird because like I'm not used to it, and like I have that like picture in my head of what like Atlanta Airport is, but this is like a whole different side of it. But they also have that AirTrain too, if you're connecting and stuff, it makes stuff like super convenient compared to like some airports where you have to walk long distances and stuff, but they have that train, so kind of a busy baggage claim area, but yeah, so just waiting on my bag and then Uber. I'm at my hotel and all I gotta say is wow. I mean, look at this freaking view, guys. My lord. This is like an aviation lover's paradise. Absolutely incredible. And for those of you who do not know where I'm currently at, I'm at the Renaissance Airport Hotel in Atlanta. And right here is runway 8 left and 8 right, for those aviation people out there. But man, this is incredible. I'll give you guys a bit of a room tour as well. Take a look here before it gets trashed by me. But wow, I mean, I don't even remember the last time I was at like a hotel, like not an Airbnb, but like specifically like a hotel and had a balcony. So it's really cool. And like, what a view to wake up to, like an two A330s, which is kind of sad, but because they're parked here, but not being used. But you can hear the planes in the background. It's awesome. Like, I can't believe it. I'm so excited. This is awesome. This makes me so happy. But anyways, thank you guys so much for coming along with me today. I hope you enjoyed coming with me on that 767-400. It's a great experience, great crew. A shame again because of COVID. There's no drink service and stuff. And I mean, I don't want to sit here and tell you the experience is ruined, but it's a different travel experience for sure with the constant mask thing and no food or beverage service along with the social distancing. I hope this vaccine can come out soon and travel can get back to normal, because I sure is gonna miss it. That's about it, guys. Thank you guys so much for coming along. I'm gonna shoot some video here tonight probably, and in the morning, and probably put it at the end of this video. But I want to thank you guys so much for coming along. I'll see you guys in my next video, wherever you are in the world, saying goodnight from Georgia, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.